Aloha and welcome. Heavy Metal Meditation 57. And this is what, November 6th, 2021. We have a small crew today. I'm very glad you're here. It's always good to play with people watching, listening. Hopefully not watching. Just close the eyes. And we're going to do a sound journey. We're going to move some energy with these metal gongs and with some glass and some quartz and some metal bowls and some tinkly things. And so we're going to go about an hour, maybe a little bit over. It'll get loud and soft and loud and soft. And then it'll go quiet for just a little bit. And when it does, just keep your breath going. Stay with your breath. Maybe scan your body if you're awake. Feel it, and then I will talk you back. Is there anyone here who's not done a sound journey? Excellent. Okay. Aurish, we'll see you on the other side. Kaim and I always start with three breaths together, honi honi style. Growing roots while we do that. I encourage you to do the same. I like to breathe deep into my belly. All the way up to the top of my chest. Gently, no stress. Hold for a few moments and then release. And then I like to pull my belly back towards my spine to really clear out all of the air. Hold for a count of two and then breathe in. We'll do that three times, and while we're doing that, we're growing roots. That'll get us all into Mama Gaia, where you can let go of things that get shaken up with the gongs that you may be ready to let go of, and can also bring nurturance up from Mama Gaia for what you need. Sometimes this brings up emotions. That's fine. They're welcome here. Cry if you need. Laugh if you need. It's all good. Come, my queen, let us do this thing. See you in an hour-ish.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. as this sound journey draws to a close. The invitation is to find your breath. No need to change it. Just notice. And allow that noticing to gently guide you back into your body, into this present moment. And in present moment awareness, I suspect you may find, as awareness flows gently back into your physical being, that you may want to spread your fingers or wiggle your toes. Or roll your ankles, or scratch your nose. I strongly encourage you that if your body makes those desires known, that you do not resist, because resistance is futile. I was reminded today that the universe really appreciates it when you ask for help, and that it really can't intervene on your behalf unless you do. So another invitation is to find some reason this week to ask for help, humbly, and see what happens. And in the conversation I had today where that was the reminder, a woman asked, well, how do you ask for help? And there were a number of answers to that, which I thought was awesome, because I think we each have our own journey. And then it doesn't really matter how you ask. But I think it may matter that you know you're asking for help. So as I mentioned at the beginning, these instruments can move a lot of energy, and some of that energy can release toxins and stuck energy places in your body. And so it's a real good idea over the next 2 or 3 days to up the intake of your water just a little bit, or maybe a whole lot. That way, if anything has gotten loosened up and is now flowing along in your bloodstream, you've got the opportunity to flush it out, to give it plenty of fluids to allow itself to flow out. Thanks for joining us. As always, we'll do the remix and post it in a few days. And if you're watching the remix, don't hesitate to smash that like button. And click the subscribe if you want to know when these go up. Thank you very much. It's an interesting ride. We'll see you. You'll see us the next time you're looking at us.
Aloha. Mahalo.
Wasn't that disappointing? Bye-bye.
No longer recording. Free to make lots of noise.